Spend any Fifa points, and we try and work our ways to the best place in the game through playing or trading. Anyway, this episode has got a lot for us. We got a bunch of packs to get through throughout the episode, a couple of games to show as well, rewards, and our first pack of the episode gives us episode, so stay tuned, and I'll just walk you through. Oh, if you've got something here, John Stones is not too bad actually for my team. Currently I've got a Premier League team, so John Stones is actually quite good. I go on to do an SBC again. I think it was one of those bronze SBC. So we complete the whole SBC. There we go, the goalkeeper and striker. Let's see what we get in these. Yeah, so I think I end up going for Copal anyway. Dortmund's got more links and stuff like that, just in case there's an SBC that comes up. And then, oh, we need Dortmund players. Well, you know, let's decided to stack up on them. So I end up. He's actually a decent goalkeeper, to be fair, on these stacks. But anyway, we end up going with him. And then striker, we end up going, oh actually, I can't remember who I end up going with, but I think we end up going with Dembele. I don't know, might not be anyway. I think I end up going with like a high raid. Yeah, I end up going Dembele, which is fair enough. So we are in another pack opening again, and here I finished the 100 finesse shots objective, which gives you a 50k pack, the easiest 50k pack you'll probably do, especially if you play a lot of FIFA. So I end up doing that, and of course we've got a bunch of other packs to open, so we'll be opening them as well in just a second. Time when I've tried this before, this theory before, but a lot of the time when you start off on FIFA, you don't actually get the best packs. I've created a couple of accounts in previous years, they're not the best, and I don't really get great packs. It's weird. You'd think if you create a new account that actually you'd get the best packs, but clearly not. For the gold pack next, let's see what we get in this. We end up getting the CDM Arnold, is it? Yeah. So we end up getting Arnold in the next pack. is fantastic, especially for us, because we do not have a lot of options in attacking areas. We don't. And when I mean options, I mean good options, not just options for options' sake. That Kingsley Coman is going to offer us a bit of variety, so I'm definitely going to see if I can incorporate him into my starting 11. I might have to change leagues and formation and stuff like that, but that's more than fine. Of course, we get Pepe as well, but I've already got a right winger, so Pepe's not the best, but anyway, still good for SBCs and stuff. We get a decent bunch of plays there, but Coleman obviously is the highlight of this. And I think I end up opening the preview pack, but again, not much really comes out of that one. I always open a preview pack anyway, but we'll see what we get out of this one. We get Kevin Trapp, okay, fair enough. Not expecting much, not going to buy the pack, because it would be a waste of money if I did that. But anyway, let's get into the more juicier parts of this video. We completed squad battles. I think we only did it up to about goal 2, if my memory serves correct, which we did. And of course, you know, you don't get the best rewards, but you do get some rewards. You get 2 packs that we went to open straight away. So we got a jumbo premium gold pack and a mixed players pack. So let's open them. Because that's not the bigger pack anyway. Let's see what we get inside. Hopefully we get something decent. And we end up getting Hamsik. Hamsik used to be fantastic back in the day. Used to be my go-to midfielder for the Serie A section at least. But the 24 gold items pack, jumbo premium gold pack. Let's see what we get inside. Is it going to be special? Oh, we have got to Richarlison. Richarlison is a decent player, from what I've heard in the game. Is if it's similar to Gabby Jesus, from what I've been told anyway. But we'll see. I'll see if I can incorporate him in my side anyway. I think I need some fresh legs up there anyway. But as we've opened our squad battles packs now, I am very much addicted to opening packs. But of course, let's jump into a game. And the first game I jump into was actually a good game. It was a good game, very hard fought game. I'm not going to show the whole game, I'm just going to show the goals and stuff. I opened the scoring with Danny Ings, as you can see. But this opponent was tough, he just gave me a hard time, to be fair. And then he goes and equalizes with, I think it is, Saka. Oh, Saka scores. And he makes it 1-0. That's stupid goal to concede anyway. He's back on the attack again, Saka's through. And this is just a simple pass, this is really poor for me anyway. Playing a high line. I think this was when I started to realise the high line thing might not be the best thing for me. I might have to sit back and change my custom tactics. But I think at the end of this game, I was feeling like I was missing something with the team that I had. You know, of course, they're not the best. They're still gold players, but they're not the best gold players. I need, you know, the top echelon ones, the ones that everyone wants to buy and stuff. So after this game, obviously I got Kingsley Coman, dropped down, well, I didn't progress in Division 8. And I was like, listen, I need to change the team up. As you can see, the team's on the screen now. I need to change it up. Before we do that, of course, we're always going to do an SBC in an episode because I'm addicted to them. But we end up doing the early access challenge SBC. Very simple, very easy. You get to the store, go and open it, and see what we get inside. Only one rare, but let's see if we can pack anything nice for our side. And we get Ruidíaz, I think. Ruidíaz, that's how you pronounce it, but he's a duplicate. So I'm probably going to have to discard him if that's the case. I'm going to have to discard him. Which is not great. But anyway, let's move on to another SBC. A gold upgrade SBC. An SBC which I will do quite a lot in this series. Because you never know what you can get in one of those packs. You can, you know, anything can walk out. Literally, you know, anything useful can walk out of that pack. But let's see. Do we get Walkout, Flames, nothing? No. But we do get somebody we do like in this game. Rafinha from Leeds. Fantastic. And we do also get Sula. I like Rafinha in real life. And I'm pretty sure I like him in the game. He's got great pace and what have you. As I said before, I felt the need to rebuild the team. So I went out and got myself virtually a whole new team. Berkey in goal, my cash is still my right back, which is not the best, but we will soldier on with Matty Cash until we find a better right back. John Stones, of course, backed him, so I wanted to get him into the side. I played 20 games with him, but he's alright. I mean, Akanji, not played any games with him. One for 4k. Decent stats on him, so we'll see how he performs. Nico Salts. 86 pace, that's all I looked at when I bought him. Oxley Chamberlain, 850 coins. He just gave decent links, so I bought him as well. Jordan Henderson, 66 pace. Decent stats as well on him, so I bought him as well. I work rates, which can be a detriment at times, but it's very good in general. Sabitzer is sound. I mean, his stats look very, very good. So I just decided, listen, I'm gonna incorporate him in my side. Right winger, Rafinha. Who I just got, wanted to use him in this side. Let's see how he performs. Richarlison up top with him. Richarlison is been doing very well for me, to be fair. Especially if you know how to use him, he's very, very good. And then the left wing, of course, is Kingsley Coman, so a decent little side. And I'll do a test run with the game to see how they perform afterwards, of course. But it looks like a decent little side, and I just built it just to see. Listen, I want to progress in the series, and I don't think using that team was ever going to get me anywhere realistically. So hopefully this side can just, you know, calm the waters and at least give me a bit more enjoyment in the game, if not better results. But anyway, I didn't manage to catch the first 20 minutes or so, but I'm showing you from that point on anyway. I'm 2-1 up at this point, so he equalises through a penalty from Fabinho. Then we go up the other end and we'll put some nice football together, to be fair. I'm very, very pleased with the way I played. And just open him up there. Kingsley Coman scores and makes it 3-2. And at this point, I'm thinking, wow, this team's performing all right. Still a bit of flaws. It feels a bit sluggish. But it's all right. It's all right. I think it's because of the midfielders I've got. They're not the best in terms of their pace and their quickness or their agility. But he goes through poor defending for me. And makes it 3 goes through again, makes it 5-3 in this instance. Then it just goes from bad to worse. He recovers the ball again. Now, this was actually where I was like, oh, maybe I can get back in the game. Coleman squares it back. It's a piece of chips, and I'm thinking it's going in. He clears it off the line. I was like, wow, cleared off the line, literally. And seconds later, he counter-attacks with Lucas Moura. And I've got my salts, my 86 base salts, bad defending. And it just goes in from 6-4. The game is virtually almost over. I get the goal back with a penalty from, I think it's a pizza anyway. Takes the penalty, Ed slots it home with 5 minutes left. Are we going to mount or come back? Are we going to get back into the game? No, we cannot, unfortunately. And the game ends up 6-5 to him. And sometimes you play with a team and it takes you one game to realize the team is not gelling. Even if you gave it time, it wouldn't perform way you wanted to. So as soon as the game finished, I looked at the plays and I decided it's probably time if we part ways. It was only one game, but I could just tell I wasn't happy with the side. I wasn't happy with the way they were performing, the way they were feeling, especially in transition when I was playing with them. They just didn't feel like a good team to me, you know. Especially I would have sold everyone, but of course, you know, it wasn't really a point. I built a new Premier League team, very standard, nothing special about it, but at least I know with the Premier League team, you know, I can play 4-4-2, I can play with wingers, I can play a bit more better football. Football that's more enjoyable, that I can win with. So I end up doing that and just changing back to like a standard Premier League team. Literally, it's not even standard, it's less than standard. And of course, as you can see on the screen, I sold the others. I sold them. Gone. And yeah, I think at this point we had a new side that we basically just shown you. It was a slightly different, a bit of a tweak. I think we put Odegaard in there, and we also bought Martial for 11k. So he goes in there as well. And it's a 4-1-3-2, I think. It is, but the central midfielder rather than a central attacking midfielder. So essentially we just got rid of everything that we didn't like about that side, and we tried to make it more exciting and fun and attacking. So this next game that I'm going to show you is the first game that I played with this new side, and it was a fun game. It was 2-2 up until the 70th minute. I was enjoying it, fluid plays, but feeling nice to play with and stuff like that. And you know, the opponent quits out. It was weird. I don't know why they quit out in that situation, but essentially we did get the win for that, which I'm pleased about, because I hate when I play a game for 90 minutes and then it just quits out, or my connection lags or something, and then I don't get the win. It's just like, wow. But anyway, we did get the win for this, which I'm happy about. Going forward, obviously, I really, really, really want to upgrade this side heavily. But before we speak about all that, let's actually look at the rewards we got. So, I think it was a Thursday, picked up my rewards for the day, of the week, should I say. Wasn't a great reward. I was looking at which ones the best rewards, which ones are going to be the ones that are going to history of my lock. Guaranteed anything in those packs, but of course, an 82 rated overall is guaranteed in this pack. Now we get another walkout. Let's see what we're gonna get here. Of course, as we know, my pack lock is not the best, but I believe we have at least a little 83 or 84 that we can use in the SBC here. Oh, we get Benji. Well, dude, it's dead on 82. Literally, right? But Benji, well, is not too bad. And Christian Eriksen, they cannot be traded, which is a bummer. But we can work around that anyway. It's not too much of an issue. Especially with a lot of SBCs and stuff. And the fact that you can do the SBCs and come back to the players if you've got duplicates and store them. So we do an SBC here where I think it's called Gimme 5. Very simple SBC. We get a prime mixed players pack at the end of it. We just look at if we, you know, can improve it or save money anywhere, but couldn't really do that. So just plow on with the SBC, finish that. So we have some items to deal with. So of course we had a duplicate version of him, so we just put him in a club again, and then we open this pack. Let's see what we get in this pack. And we're getting anything decent, no balls, no walkouts or nothing. We get another Christian Eriksen. So I'm pretty sure at this point again I have to do another SBC, because this is like, wow, I got another Christian Eriksen. Anyway, no upgrade pack again, but at least we can trade some of these players. We can sell them on if we don't, or if they are valuable anyway. But since I got up, I think in the previous SBC I put cash, my cash into the SBC, which I had no right back, so I went out and got a very, very good right back, probably one of the decent ones in this game, Ricardo Pereira. And as you can see, our squad is coming through nicely. I'm actually quite happy with where it was or where it is at the end of this episode. But anyway, guys, I have progressed a bit on from obviously this point in time, so episode will probably come out maybe end this week or start of next week. Again, we'll be showing a lot more rewards, what happens in foot champs and stuff like that. As always, you know, support the channel, hit the like button, as it helps the channel so much. Subscribe.